Hi, this is Dave Sulcer at BMC Software. Welcome to the first installment in a five-part series showing you what you need to know to get the tools and build and deploy an application for Innovation Suite. Over the course of these five videos, we'll set up our IDE, create a Maven project, add some code to it, deploy it to Innovation Studio, and then finally package it for deployment. So let's get started. In this video, we're going to look over my shoulder while we install the tools and the SDK and the IDE. All the tools you need are described on this documentation page. It is important to get the right versions of things. For example, when you're getting Maven, you really do need Maven 3.2.1. And on their website, there's an archive that allows you to get exactly that version. Similarly with Node.js, you need 6.2.1. Eclipse requires, well, you do need the Neon version of Eclipse. You can get the latest one of those, no problem. Make sure you get the matching plugin for AspectJ. Verify you've got the right tools. This is really important. You do this using the commands like Java, MVN, using the dash version or dash dash version, depending on the tool. Make sure the version numbers match up what the toolset requires. Once you have all these tools installed, the build system for Innovation Suite, which is based on Maven, will use them to generate the project code for Java and JavaScript development based on the Innovation Suite SDK. The RX SDK home environment variable has to be set using your operating system. I set it to this place where I know I'm going to install the SDK. It looks like our tools are good to go, but we do need the SDK itself. This is just a zip file you can download from this same place in the documentation. Download that zip file and then move it to your correct location and unzip it. This zip file contains the standard library, which is used by our clients, and it has to be found at compile time, which is why you have that environment variable pointing to this place. Once you unzip it here, you don't need the zip file, obviously. If you notice, the lib folder that you've unzipped has the jar files for the SDK. In order to get these into your local Maven repository, go to the lib folder and run Maven clean install. If you're not familiar with how to use Maven, you can check out the Maven website, which has a lot of good information about Maven. Okay, your SDK is now fully installed. As a sanity test, I like to try to CD to the environment variable RxSDK home and make sure it's the correct place that I'm expecting. Looks good. Thanks for watching, and now you try it. Download the correct tools, complete the verification, and then you'll be ready to move on to the next video in our series, in which we will generate and deploy a bundle using the Maven archetype. As always, find out more at developers.bmc.com.